This is what we call a zone plate. Zone plate is an image forming optical device which is based on Fresnel's theory of half period zones. So you can call it as a special diffracting screen which is designed to put a stop on a passage of light from alternate half period zones. Now here we will see two kinds of zone plates. One we will be calling it to be positive and one we will be calling it to be negative. This kind of zone plate is made up by drawing large number of concentric circles. So as you see here, middle part is white. So whatever is white, that is transparent to light. Whatever is black, there it is blocked. Now from Fresnel theory up till now, we are aware that our radius is a function of three things, n, b and lambda, where n is number of zones, b is distance between obstacle and the screen, and third, lambda is wavelength. So this is also dependent on wavelength. As we are going to change the wavelength, that will also affect our radius of the zone. Now, what is the difference over here? Up till now, we were having zones which we were imagining in air. So if I consider a point mid-air, which we were calling pole of a wavefront, then there we would assume that, or that we will create center of zone, and from there we are going to draw concentric zones, and those zones would give rise to a particular amplitude at a point. Whether it would be negative or positive, that will depend upon the number of zones that will fit into one aperture. So this was the equation which we took for when our wavefront is planar. If our wavefront is circular, then our modified equation was 1 by a plus 1 by b equals m lambda by r square. The change here is, now we have introduced a. So what is the difference? The only change would be a is distance between source and the obstacle. Now obviously, which kind of plate is more better for us? Because now we know from zone theory that the first zone has maximum amount of impact on creating intensity of light. Therefore, this kind of plate is called as a positive plate. If I reverse this, that kind of plate is called as a negative plate. For a zone plate, we need to have radius which is going to be proportional to root of n. If I take a piece of paper and I draw concentric circles, each with the radius square root of n, then if my first radius is root of 1, second would be root of 2, root of 3, root of 4, and so on. This way you go up till root of n. And then, so that is what is being depicted over here. So here if I see my first zone, this is my first zone, which is transparent to light. 2 is blocked and 9 is transparent. So in this case, how we are going to think about the amplitude because of this zone plate? In this case, I can take this amplitude in terms of amplitude because of first zone, because it is transparent. 2, I'm not going to take. 3, which sign I should take, positive or negative? I will take a positive sign because first and second zone are off by pi reversal. So we do A1 minus A2, but A3 and A1 is in sync with each other. Both are in same phase. So A3, similarly, 4, which we don't consider, is already blocked. A5 plus A7 and A9. Remember, this I'm talking about if I've set my wavefront in such a manner that you know when we are imagining this wavefront, in air we are imagining that I will have first zone with some radius R1. So here is the ideal situation when first zone is just filling up my first radius of the zone plate. Second zone is just here. Third zone is just here. When everything is just fitting in. So I'm imagining a Fresnel's zone, which is having these radius R1, R2, R3. So these are radius for Fresnel zone, which are exactly matching with R1, R2, R3 for zone plate. It will, every time it will not be possible that your first zone, which we are imagining in air, would be allowed, would fit exactly first zone of zone plate. Then if not, then what will happen? So you can have a condition when larger number of zones are allowed to pass through first zone of zone plate. Remember, our Fresnel zones are mid-air, and if by chance that R1 matches with this R1, then only we are going to get this ideal situation. I can have a condition where, let's say, first three zones are fitting into this zone. What do I mean? That means, let's say, R3 equals R1. In that case, what will happen? Radius of third Fresnel zone, which comprise of zone 1, 2, and 3, all three together, is equivalent to R1 on zone plate. So it would be, the blocked region is next three, right? So now your R6 will be equal to which one? On zone plate, it will come where? R2, right? Now when we write for the next one, the part which is black in my zone plate is not now allowing the next three zones. So we don't consider 4, 5, and 6. Now we come to next. So it would be 7 because it's positive, 8 reverse, and 9 positive. Okay. So because I restricted my zone plate only to 9 zones. So now what will happen to amplitude? You have 4 positive and 2 negative. So your intensity on the screen will still remain bright. But instead, what will happen? The intensity at the point would reduce. This is the simplest zone plate which I have considered, which has only 4 zones drawn onto it. Now here, when the light is coming from a particular source, let's say this is my source, and light with circular wavefront reaches here. What will happen on this zone plate? Diffraction is going to occur. As soon as my wavefront reaches here, it is going to suffer diffraction because of transparent plate. So a wavefront is reaching over here. Then diffraction will occur. So I can take my first zone to be taken as a circular aperture. This circular aperture will diffract light, and we will have a screen somewhere at a far distance, which will give us a point. Now here, this bright point will be decided by the focal length of the zone plate. How you define focal length of the zone plate? Focal length of the zone plate is taken up in the same equation that we have already done. 1 by A plus 1 by B equals M lambda by R square. The only change here now is our R's are restricted. We don't have all M available. For a positive plate, M is only odd. And for negative plate, M is only even. If my wavefront is planar, which is the most simplistic case, I will only take 1 by B as M lambda by R square. And if B, which is the focusing distance, if I rewrite it as, so I can write F. So if I want to write it in terms of F, it would be R square by M lambda. And remember this, to put this subscript FM. दिस मीन्स वॉट? वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग फोकल लेंथ फॉर एमथ जोन बिकॉज यू नो दैट एस एम इज चेंजिंग आवर डिस्टेंस ऑफ फोकसिंग विल ऑल्सो चेंज. सो इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट एम इक्वल्स वन देन इफ माई फर्स्ट जोन इज देयर लेट्स से एट दिस पर्टिकुलर बी वी आर गेटिंग द शार्प पॉइंट. नाउ रिमेंबर दैट वॉज आर दिस इज वन. सो नाउ यू रिमेंबर दैट फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर सेट ऑफ ए बी वी हैव नाउ वी हैव फिजिकल लिमिटेशन. अर्लियर वेन आई वॉज चेंजिंग बी वॉट वॉज हैपनिंग अर्लियर आई वॉज डिफाइनिंग माई आर एस रूट ऑफ एन बी लैमडा. सो वेन एवर आई वॉज चेंजिंग माई बी वॉट वॉज चेंजिंग एन वॉज चेंजिंग बट नाउ वी डोंट हैव दैट प्रोविजन. नाउ आवर रेडियस इज फिक्स्ड विच इज अ फिजिकल लिमिटेशन गिवन बाय द जोन प्लेट. सो इफ आई हैव अ कंडीशन वेयर आर वन बिकॉज ऑफ एक्चुअल वेव फ्रंट इज मैचिंग विथ आर वन ऑफ माई जोन प्लेट देन माई बी विल ऑल्सो बी फिक्स्ड फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर लैमडा. इन दैट केस यू विल डिफाइन एफ वन एस आर स्क्वायर बाय लैमडा विच विल बी फर्स्ट फोकल लेंथ. सो आई कैन राइट एफ वन एस आर स्क्वायर बाय लैमडा. सेंस इफ यू हैव अ लेंस वी जस्ट गेट वन कॉमन फोकल पॉइंट बट इन केस ऑफ जोन प्लेट यू विल हैव मल्टीपल फोकल पॉइंट डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द नंबर ऑफ जोन्स. सो if I'm keeping my screen at f1 that will be the sharpest point which will be because of your first zone. Then if you want to see the focal point because of third zone you need to bring the screen closer and closer. So second would be f1 by 3, third would be f1 by 5, there would be no f1 by 2 or f1 by 4 because we are having only odd number of zones. Central circle of a zone plate has a radius of 0.07 centimeters, light of wavelength 5000 angstrom is coming from first object at infinity, second object at 140 centimeter away. Find the position of principal image in each case. So what is given to us? Your R is 0.07 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter, or write it as 7 into 10 raised to minus 4 meters, and lambda is given as 500 nanometer or 5 into 10 raised to minus 7 meters. In first case you are given object is at infinity, so in first case you are going to use the equation as you know the equation fm equals rm square by m times lambda. It is the principle, so m would be 1. Okay, so that is also given to you. R, so 7 into 10 raised to minus 4 square by 1 into lambda, which is 5 into 10 raised to minus 7. Answer is 0.98, or I can write 98 centimeters, right? For the next one, we are given A as well. So we will have 1 by A plus 1 by B equals, again my M is 1 here, M lambda by R square. So that will give us A to be 147. B is what we need to calculate. So I can write that in the form of F. M is 1. It is again 5 into 10 raised to minus 7 divided by R, which is 7 into 10 raised to minus 4 whole square. So I can write at 294 centimeters, right? There is another way to do it. If I compare, this is your focal length, right? Now, since we are comparing this as a convergent lens, we can also write it as 1 by A, which is the object distance, 1 by B, which is the image distance. Because A is the distance from source to zone plate, and B is the distance from zone plate to screen. Now, which is how we write it for lens, 1 by U plus 1 by B equals 1 by F. So if this I write, my F I've already calculated, which you got it as 98 centimeters. So that way also you can do. So you can again write 147 plus 1 by B that you're calculating, which will be equal to 1 by 98. This will also fetch you the same result for B as 298. So what we calculated in the first part is basically principal focal length of zone plate. This is called as principal focal length. So what is the meaning of principal focal length? If you have a light which is coming from infinity, and where it will be focused, that we take as a focal length. The focal length that you get is your principal focal length. So that if you use this equation, still it will give you the same result.